Now since we have made the chunks, it's time to make the smoke trails with the help of FumeFX. So first of all, we will do some necessary changes here. So go to particle view and I delete spin, rotation, shape instance. Instead of shape instance, I'll insert shape and we'll choose sphere 20 sides, and in birth I'll use only 10 particles. And with the PF source I can select it, change the viewport visibility percentage to 100%. So now we have 10 particles. And in force I'll remove drag for now. Now see this in perspective viewport. Let's decrease the gravity strength a bit, reduce the speed and divergence values. Now it looks something like this. Since it's going quite fast, so use drag now. So bring back the drag force now. Let's see how does it behave after changing the values. And in speed, we may increase the speed, decrease the divergence and variation to something like this. In birth, increase the amount to 15. In speed, increase the variation. Actually, you have to check each and every time which settings give you the desired result. It should go up a little bit. Add one more force, wind, in the scene. First of all, add wind in the force list. It's going quite high, so decrease the strength. Give some turbulence and frequency and decrease scale value. So it looks something like this. Now go to the camera view. It's going quite high. First, generate the safe frame here. then go to shape and decrease the shape quite low. Now it seems the speed is quite high, so go to speed and down it a bit. Now it looks something like this. It looks pretty good. I will work with FumeFX. So first of all, go to FumeFX and then make its container like this. Make sure all the particles be inside the container. Now go to helpers, FumeFX, particle source, and create a particle source in the viewport. And click here and select the PF source icon. And you can see the PF source icon in the list. Now select the container and open the output preview window and FumeFX UI. On FumeFX UI, inside General tab, spacing is quite high right now, so keep it as 1.5, and then go to Object Source tab and select the FumeFX Particle Source. Inside Simulation, keep the quality as 7 and then play the simulation. And you can clearly see in the output preview how it looks like. Now let's see it in the full resolution. So pause the simulation and then with the single frame selected, let's see how does it look like. Oh, it's not rendering. Okay, first of all, let's stop the simulation. Earlier we had just paused it. So stop the simulation first and then render the scene. And you'll find something like this. Smoke trails with fire elements. See, it's alpha version. Now let's tweak some more options. Increase the quality a bit. You might have seen these dots. Actually, these are the spheres. So to eliminate them from rendering, go to Particle View, Display, and change the type from Geometry to None. So now if you simulate it again, you won't get these dots anymore. Now once the simulation is done, go to Rendering, Render Setup, and select the range from 0 to 100, same dimension, and render the frames in TGF format in 32 bits. Since I have already rendered the frames, so once you are done with rendering, check the next video for the final compositing with all the elements together in After Effects.